Hello, family. We're Bob and Penny Lord. Put on your walking shoes and come with us on a pilgrimage to Tolentino, Italy, to the shrine of St. Nicholas, Super Saint of the Week, Champion of the Souls in Purgatory.
And we have with us here Fra Mario, who is an Augustinian brother who is going to share with us the life of St. Nicholas of Tolentino.
Ecco, allora San Nicola da Tolentino, un santo che è vissuto nel Medioevo e spesso viene confuso con quello di Bari per la colpa del nome.
St. Nicholas of Tolentino was born in the year 1245, not far from Tolentino, where he spent most of his life as a religious. His elderly parents had not been able to bear a child. Late in life, they made a pilgrimage to Bari, petitioning St. Nicholas of Bari to intercede with the Lord that they might bring a child into the world, never suspecting the impact that child would have on the history of the church. St. Nicholas was born, and his parents named him after St. Nicholas of Bari in thanksgiving. He was the gift of their golden years. They offered him back to the Lord as his mother committed him to God at his baptism. Parents having a problem conceiving often turned to St. Nicholas of Tolentino, patron saint of difficult births, because of the circumstances surrounding his own birth. From an early age, Nicholas longed for the religious life. One day the Lord sent him to an Augustinian church to hear an Augustinian preach. And what should the homily be about but the gospel passage, love not the world, nor the things that are in the world. The world is passing away. It is believed that it was this preacher who filled Nicholas with the great desire which would catapult him into serving the Lord and only the Lord for the rest of his life in the Augustinian community. He joined the Augustinian community while still a child, and before he was 18 years old, he became a brother.
Tradition that when he first started as a young brother, before he became a priest, he was the doorkeeper. Now, many famous saints who are finding this out have been doorkeepers, like Blessed Andre of Montreal, Sister Faustina, St. Nicholas of Tolentino, St. Martin de Porres. These were doorkeepers. Now, the doorkeepers, St. Bernadette of Lourdes, doorkeepers have an important part in the church. Now, what Nicholas would do when the poor people came asking for food, he just kept giving and giving and giving, gave sometimes to the point where his superiors got a little bit upset with him because there was nothing left for them. They gave it all to the poor people. But this is who Nicholas was, and everybody loved him.
It was during this time, his early days in the Augustinian community, while being doorkeeper, that we hear of Nicholas' first miracle. A child came to the door with his parents. It was obvious he suffered a serious physical malady. Nicholas put his hand on the child's head and said,